the next day. I left everything as it was. Alright, I just had to go off and do other things, man, innit? Alright, so this is very important. I just want to let you guys know. When you feel like you're getting fatigued and you're getting a bit tired of this, just take a break, man. Walk away. Come back the next day fresh, do you know what I'm saying? So you're going to have a clear mind and you'll have a clear idea what you want to do and what you want to achieve. But before we get to this today, I want to show you guys something. Alright. Check this out. Wild weather, man. What's going on? Holy. Shit. So this is how the wind was blowing all night yesterday, alright? And look, I had a near miss, man. Check this out. Almost took out my bloody man cave. Let's get back to it. But before I do, I want to show you guys something else. You see? This is all the grease, all the mess that came out. Alright, so I'm going to chuck all of this away, clean this pot up for the next diff. Alright everyone, I was just rummaging through my parts bin and look what I found. I found my shims, but check this out. Team Durango, baby. Who remembers Team Durango? Oh my days, this proper takes me back, man. Well, they've been out of business for, I don't know, 3-4 years now, but yeah. What a shame, man, innit? But I used to like their stuff, man. Their stuff was really nice. I used to really like their stuff. They're like a, they were a sister company to Armour. So yeah, it's a shame they're not around anymore, man. But yeah, these are lightened diff kits, basically internals for I think it was, I don't even remember what it was called, but it was the same. It was for the Talion or the Typhoon, basically. So I wanted to do a completely lightened Typhoon in it, but I never got around to it. But I've still got the internals in here, you know, all the spider gears. And look at this, it's got a composite crossbar. So yeah, it's just all designed, like everything is shaved down, like it's like really lightened, all of it. Yeah, I remember. But I never got around to that project, man. I don't know, maybe in the future. Yeah, I've got some Kyosho shims here as well. So yeah, man. Kyosho makes really good shims, I have to say. They're like stronger in it. They just last longer. Oh yeah, and I've got some Mugensuki ones. Now they've by far, Mugensuki makes some serious shims, bro. And their shims come coated like that. Bro, perfect. But only thing is, they're very expensive, man, innit? Their shims are not cheap. Alright, so I think I'm gonna see if the Mugen shims, I don't think they're gonna fit. They look massive. I need like smaller ones. Okay everyone, so the Mugensuki shims, they don't fit. Straight up. I've tried them and their internal diameter is a little bit smaller. Look, you see? It just doesn't fit, man. Can't pop it in. You see? Okay, so backup plan failed. Not to worry, I have backup plans for my backup plans. So this is basically my son's Hoppy King Trooper parts bag. All right, and there's some shims in here, so let's try if these ones work. All right, moment of truth. Let's see. Please work, please work. Yes, that's what I'm talking about. You see, my theory is a sound theory, man, innit? Always, always have a backup plan. And if you can, if you're a bit like me, have a backup plan for your backup plan. Alright, now look, yeah, the Mugensuki ones are better shims, but they didn't fit. But I'm just lucky, man, I got these. Do you know what I'm saying? Now, I can shim my diffs and just go on my merry way. Alright. Everything is still running smoothly, there's no binding. That's perfect. Yep. Alright, so I'll put one on there, like that. And I'll probably put one here. Let's get a shim. Right, man. What the hell? What is it so windy for? Let's try this out and see. Yep, I'm happy with that. Let's check this, check the movement. All right, that's perfect. There's just enough movement, but it's not excessive. All right, I'm happy, people. Okay, so now we can start filling her up. Now we know what we have to do. All right, so if you guys get this platform, if you want to do this upgrade, hell yeah, man, do it. I think it's worth it. Like, I did the same thing. I shimmed my diffs on my armor crayon, and I'm still using the original diffs, original spider gears, original everything, bruv. Okay, so here we go, look. So what I'm going to do now, this is how I like pouring my silicone shock oil. Alright, I'll leave this out. I'm going to fill the bottom bit in. Alright, you can leave the first spider gear in. And you can fill this bit up, and then I'll put this in, you know, just to get all the, you know, it's just easier to get into the nooks and crannies, you know. This is the center, so okay, 500k. Alright. And just start pouring. See, this is thick, bro. This is some thick ass shock oil. I mean, diff oil. Get that. Paste this. Did I leave the. Yeah, look. Be careful. Make sure everything is in there. Didn't go in. But it fell out. All of that. Didn't switch my phone off. Sorry, everyone. Here we go. Now, give you a little whirl. Push it down properly. And you will see as you turn it around, it will take all the silicone shock down. But you will have to like push everything down because it's going to try to pop out. Bit more. Bloody hell, what was that? Air pocket. I think that should be enough. All right, so now what I wanted to tell you guys was, don't forget your grub screw. Alright, make sure, especially if you've got grub screw, make sure you put that in, man, innit? And I can see a little bit of oil coming out there. So that's not good. I should have put this in before. Never mind, let's put it in now, before we forget completely. Don't go crazy. That's fine. It's nice and flush. That's it. So let that sit for a while. All right, let's do the other side. Okay, so your out drive is already greased up. Oh, bearing. Where's the damn bearing? Here we go. Don't forget your bearing, man, innit? Like I said, I have done that before. It's a pain in the ass, like, to put right. Okay. Get your out drive in. It'll be easier to show you guys how to do the O-ring on this. There we go. Pop in like that. And then make sure it's seated. There you go. See? Well, once you pop one side, the other side wants to pop out. Just make sure it's seated in properly, like evenly, you know? And it will help once, like, you get your shim on, it will help. Alright. Get your shim. Put that down there like that. The grease does help. Clean your hands and line it up. There you go. Alright, now all you have to do is line up this pin with that groove. Oil will pop out. I think I might have overdone it, but let's see. Actually, that's perfect. Wow. It does pay off, man. The more maintenance you do, you get better at it. Give a little wipe down. Okay. Yeah, a little bit of oil popped out, but that's minor, man. That's expected. Okay, one thing I forgot. Can you guys tell what I forgot? This needs to come out again. Alright, I forgot the damn O-ring. This O-ring. Don't forget, because you will have leaks. Here we go, let's put this guy on. There we go, done. Just gonna get some extra grease and put it on this O-ring, man. Protect this O-ring. It's gonna help you in the future, you know. Make sure this grease doesn't dry out or nothing. Just dab it on there, just like that. All right, so now you can put the spare gear on. Just like before, line it up. There we go, perfect. All right, so that's that. Line up your screw holes. Get some of that oil out. If it's sticking out at all, there. Okay, so before I go any further, I'm going to clean up my hardware. All right, make sure you clean it with alcohol. So my daughter just came back. She was outside, and as you can see, she wants to work on her car. So come on, Amma, screw them in. I'll hold this thing for you. There you go. Keep going.
I think I need
to. Careful. Oh. Come on. Sorry. Keep going. All the way. All the way down.
I only have to go slower because this is actually still tight in.
Yeah, can go slow.
Because I don't want to rush.
We don't know. We don't rush in this house.
I don't want to rush my car.
Yes.
So much. I'm just gonna go slow.
You saw it now.
It's nearly down.
I know. Go on. Keep going.
When it's touching down here, let's do the next one.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna do the opposite side, okay? Opposite. Because it has to be torqued down evenly, okay?
The same.
Yeah. Exactly. It has to be screwed down the same amount on each position. Okay.
I didn't know that.
Well, you know
now.
Can
you tell me when to stop?
I'll tell you when to stop. Keep going. Keep that straight. Don't try not to bend your screwdriver. Okay.
This is not even my.
Keep going.
This is not even my tools. This is your tools.
Yeah, but we can start a tool bag for you.
Yeah.
Okay. Shall we move on now? Hang on. Let go. Take your screwdriver out. Okay. Now you put it in here. Okay, now we do the opposite side. Alright, now keep going.
Do you mean go this way,
huh?
That way? Do you mean you...
Yeah, let's put this on here.
Do you mean you go this way,
scratching
that
up
way,
the table.
This way, that way, like that?
Yeah, you have to do it in a star pattern. Okay, so we started on this screw.
I thought
so we come to this one, then this one, then this one.
Daddy, I thought you wanted to do this one, this one, this one, this one.
No, that's going round in a circle. I can understand why you want to do that.
Or we could just do forwards, backwards, left, right.
Yeah, that's what you have. You have to do a star pattern. You got to do the opposite side. Yeah. Okay, come on now. Let's screw this in. Alright, let me hold the screwdriver straight for you. There you go. Now you keep turning.
Daddy.
Keep going. Yes.
You have to hold both of the sides, this one and that one.
Well, yeah. I've got two hands. The opposite. So I can help you.
That me and you are a builder.
Yeah.
That we're not twins.
No, we're not twins.
Well, we look. We seem like twins, like broken legs.
Yes, you had a broken leg. I remember. I got a broken leg now.
Both of us have broken legs.
Mm. Well, not anymore. You're better now. Come on.
No, not my leg. It's still not gone. The fingers.
Oh yeah, the graze the other day. You have so many accidents, darling. How am I supposed to keep track? Every day you got new injuries. You're so much like me. I was like you when I was a kid. I still always get in trouble. Okay, let go. Can Daddy check something? Careful. Let me hold the screwdriver straight for you.
Sometimes I get a little bit frustrated.
It's all right. Main thing is to stay calm and to enjoy what you're doing.
Sometimes you get frustrated, do you?
I get frustrated all the time, sweetheart. Daddy doesn't have much patience. I have to work on that.
This is going to be a lot of work to do.
This is going to be a lot of work, darling. This is because, just the first one.
Because this is all the stuff that we need to put on the car.
Yeah.
We have to screwdriver everything out to take check.
Yeah, that's the good oil. Yeah.
Daddy, if it's not good oil, do I have to buy some new oil?
Well, Daddy's got some oil there. We can use that. We can use some of Daddy's oil.
I think it's nearly done in.
Okay, let go. Let Daddy check. Let go, because we don't want to over-torque it. It's going to damage it. Let me just do the last bit. There we go. Now, let's do this bit. Hang on. Let me put it in for you. There we go. Put the screwdriver in. There you go.
It's actually a hole on the screwdriver. A little bit behind a screwdriver. I don't even know how to see it.
Screwdriver. Yeah. Tell me when you're tired and Daddy will take over. Okay?
Okay.
Your brother's singing the Lion King. Can you hear? Go on, keep going.
Do you know all the songs about Lion King?
I don't know. Ask him if he knows all the songs.
When did Fish Bob get to
ask? By singing the most famous one.
Yeah, he sings very bad songs.
I know, he's not a very good
singer. And he doesn't know how to play guitars everywhere.
Alright, let go. Let Daddy check if it's enough. Alright.
Daddy, what's this? Daddy, what's this?
That's silicone shock oil, darling.
Are we going to put this on the car?
No, that's inside here. This oil.
Do you have the screwdriver this and then put it in?
Yeah, our Daddy took all of this off and I put some new oil in there for you. So your car's going to run nice and smoothly.
Well, why are we going to put... Wait, Daddy?
Hang on, let go.
Why are we going to put that?
Okay, done.
Yeah, what's this thingy for?
That's for your... What, this? This thing?
No, this one.
Oh, that's where your antenna is going to go for your receiver.
Oh, do you mean this one? You mean on top?
Not on top, no.
The yellow thingy.
No.
Is it going to go in here?
No, remember you said you wanted to make a flag out of it?
Yeah.
So we'll make a flag out of it.
But how are we going to make it?
Make what?
A flag.
I'm sure Daddy can work something out.
What's this for? Is it goes in here?
It's the same thing as this screwdriver, but you use a ratchet with that. You see that? You can use that. Put that in there. Put that in the slot. Look, turn it around. Let me show you. Put that in the slot. Put the other end in the slot. No, not that way. To flip it around. Flip it around. Flip this around the bit. Yeah, let's show you. Flip it. Goes in there like that. You see? Just makes it easier to screw stuff down. Alright.
I did it. I'm twisting it.
Well done.
I can just try it down.
Okay, everyone. So I've torqued everything down. As you can see, it's all done. Thanks to my daughter for helping me out. Giving Daddy a hand.
Yeah.
Alright, everyone, center diff is done. Alright, let's move on.
Daddy? Can you do these for in here?
Yeah. That's actually for your battery tray. Alright, do you want to say bye to everyone?
Bye.
All right, everyone, with all of that done today, I just want to thank all my subscribers, all my viewers. Thank you very much for watching and tuning in. I hope you guys stay safe. So until next time, look after yourself, everyone. And I'll speak to you guys next time.